Welcome to TutorASRumale, only knowledge, nothing else. Subscribe and click on the bell icon for updates on new videos. Like, comment and share it with your friends. Your comments and suggestions are most welcome.
We are now going to see the LaTeX, how to use it. In second video, we'll start with the basics. So before starting with directly using the LaTeX, we must have to know what is requirement. A file organization is very important whenever we go for creating anything which we can call as a what you can say our project. So either is a software or a documentation. So first create this folders. First go to this new, okay, and folder. I'm creating here folder. Here I given the name to this folder as ASRLTXWSP, ASR LaTeX workshop. This is my folder in which I'm going to save all the LaTeX file. In this LaTeX folder, workshop folder, I'm having one folder created to organize all my images. And I'm giving name to this folder as IMG. Okay. Then the next folder that I'm going to create to organize all my bibliographic or reference files within which. So I'm going to give name to that folder as BIB. My computer is a bit slow, so I will see it's actually loading the things. So here we are creating this folder. I'm saying BIB. Okay, BIB folder is created, and other folders are required which we are not going to create right now. We'll go with the flow. So these are the two folders. So we created ASRLTXWSP folder in which we created BIB and IMG. One care you should have to take is that never give the folder a name with spaces, because LaTeX uses the in Unix or Linux system. The folder name with the spaces like my space documents is not accessible in LaTeX. So we created this folder thing. So ASR LTXWSP folder in which we have BIB and IMG folder. Now let's start with the LaTeX editor. So here we are having this LaTeX editor TechMaker. I'm already having my system installed here. So just to give you the instruction on how to install the LaTeX, you can go through my first video. This first thing, that is first install, because we are installing working on the Windows. Okay, or even in any system, first install, you have to first install ghost script. Okay, after this ghost script, you have to install miktex. This is what the LaTeX engine, miktex. And then after this miktex, you have to install your TechMaker editor. Now the miktex is coming embedded with the TechWorks LaTeX editor. The TechWorks LaTeX editor requires some expertise from the beginners, and for beginners TechMaker is very useful. There are other editors available. You can go through my videos in LaTeX essentials and know about it. So once these three things are installed correctly, that is first you are installing this ghost script. You first install the ghost script, then install the miktex. Okay, then install the miktex, then install the TechMaker. Now when you install this ghost script, miktex and TechMaker, you will get your LaTeX working properly. So here having this completing editor TechMaker. So this is the installation sequence for LaTeX. We'll start with LaTeX work. Here you in editor, here having this source viewer as menu. Okay, here you are having this message log. Here you are running the structure. Okay, here you are using the source viewer, and likewise. So if you select this, you will get the things. For example, if I select the message log, the message log windows appear here. If I deselect it, it will go up. I'm simply keeping this structure and actually this our only source viewer on. So source viewer is on. So simply we are creating the new file. Now if you say new, okay, you have this untitled. You have to save this as. So say save as. So here you are going to save this. we just created this folder, okay, in this disk drive here, ASR LTX WSP. In this folder I'm going to save this file using minimum working example mwe.tex as its extension, okay. So giving the name of the file, this anything which comes after the percentage sign in LaTeX is considered as comment. Here I'm giving the name to this file mwe.tex, minimum working example tex, okay. After this, anyway, the every command of the LaTeX starts with a document class, okay. This document class backslash command is the start of AD command in LaTeX, backslash document class. This portion, the brackets after this document class, they include all the required parameters for your documents, like what is the size of your document, what will be the base font of your document, and likewise, let's say suppose the size of your document is A4 paper by default, okay, and you want 12 point font as your base font for the entire document, so your weightage for the font will be 12 point. Now there are different type of document types. First document type is letter, okay. Another document type versatilely used is article. Another document type we generally use for creating the reports is report, okay. We are going to learn this LaTeX basics now with the article document. So here I am this document class, A4 paper as the size of the document class, 12 point is the main fonts, the text body text font size, article is the document type. This is done. After this you simply have to write here begin document. Now you can see this when you are typing this thing, the tech maker is already giving us hint, and so we won't require to memorize all the commands in their entirety, okay, for this. So every command in LaTeX always starts with backslash, okay. So anything with a backslash in LaTeX is the LaTeX command. Anything with this percentage sign written in this source code is considered as comment and simply get ignored by the LaTeX compiler, okay. Now this portion from document class to begin document, this portion is called as preamble. Preamble, if you are familiar with HTML, this is the head part of the document, okay. So here you can include the different packages. So let's say I'm simply including the standard packages for the LaTeX. So first we'll go with some package. The command for this package is for mathematics, because whenever you are having this LaTeX or you can say we research article or something, the most frequently used things are the mathematical symbols. So you have to have these packages for mathematics or mathematical research. I'm seeing mathematical research here, okay. So the command to have these packages is use package. There are two versions for this use package. This is the first version which we are not going to use, and this is the second version, that without brackets. So that brackets is always giving you the option. So we are using the packages for mathematics. These are the different packages. AMS stands for American Mathematical Society, okay. AMS Maths, then you are having AMS Sim. So you know that is SYMB Sim is the mathematical symbols particular. AMS Fonts, so you can go with the different type of fonts. You can have the theorem, AMS THM is package for that. And if you want your mathematics set in Times New Roman style, that is straight mathematics, you can have this Math PTMX package here. So you got these four packages which are sufficient to create any mathematical equations or mathematical typesetting. Okay, so this is the first thing that you require whenever you are having the document. In document you require to add the graphics, okay. Right now we are not going to create any graphics using the LaTeX command. Instead we are going to simply import a graphic, already created graphic or something, images. So we are using here, okay, the graphics package, okay. So I'm seeing here the graphics package, PHICS graphics package for importing the graphics. Okay, this is not for creating the graphics, this is for importing the graphics, and the package is here. You have to use use package, and now you're seeing use package graphics GRAPHIC and X, not S. This graphics actually call all the bundle of the packages. So this is what your preamble. If you see this is called as your preamble. Anything which falls, actually anything which falls between document plus command and begin document command, this is called as the part preamble. So here the highlighted part is preamble part, and in preamble part you are giving all those commands which are global to the LaTeX document. And likewise, then I will go with the body part. Body part is what which falls between begin and end document. Just like C, we are having only one main function in a program. In the LaTeX document, you will always have only one document, that is begin document and end document environment. Okay, this is called as environment. Begin document, end document is the environment, and the complete LaTeX, anything written after this document is simply ignored by the LaTeX compiler. Okay. So here I'm simply writing as simple sentence, welcome to LaTeX. Okay, welcome to LaTeX. And now we are saving this file. We already saved this as a mw.tex. This is the file name that we are given to this. We saved this file, and here you are having the number of compilers to choose from: Quick Build, LaTeX, DYPS, PDF LaTeX, and likewise. So we stick with the PDF LaTeX because that will directly generate the PDF file. So here, if you see in the folder, we are having this MWE file. Now when we compile this file using PDF LaTeX, what happens? LaTeX creates different files. Now we have to see whether there are any errors or not. So it's that is AMS Maths STY not found. So we have to see, it's AMS Math actually. So simply see, we got no error here, and this code is generated. Here is your source file, here is the intermediate files, and this is the final output. Let's see the final output first in the PDF viewer. Here you are having these three viewing: DVI file, PS file, and PDF file. So we are going to stick with the PDF and say simply here, if you click on this, you can go with the PDF viewer. So when you say PDF viewer, this welcome to LaTeX is type here in the PDF file. Now if you want to make something, why to use LaTeX? Okay, now these two backslashes always show the new line character in LaTeX. Okay, just make this happen with any word processor. Actually, whatever I'm showing here is not for what purpose the LaTeX is mean, but this is a simple thing. You have this welcome to LaTeX. If you see, this tab is added automatically. Just make this happen with any word processor is a command. Okay, now you can set the length of this LaTeX thing. For example, if I add in bracket after the new line character 5 millimeter, okay, and compile this after, say, okay, when you compile the array, you get this space increase automatically. But if I make this minus 5 millimeter, and if I compile this, you will get something like this. Okay, now this output, whatever we got here, okay, if you go with this output is simply impossible with any word processor. And this is what you can say, the capacity of LaTeX. We are not going to use LaTeX for doing such silly things. It's a very, very powerful software. We are simply going to use it for creating very beautiful documents. I think this will complete the first basic of the LaTeX. But you just want to show something else. Say suppose you want to create the new paragraph, new para. Okay, and let's say suppose you want to create other new para. I just added some random text. So you need to see this space are there, everything. Now let's just suppose while typing here again on the new para, the new para is, and just added space and like this. So here you'd see, yeah, we added extra space. Here there is extra space. Now we are simply compiling this after saving the file. When we feed the PDF, we'll say that welcome to LaTeX, just make this happen. And every new para is having this tab set, okay? And the new para is, the space is gone. If you see in source, your space is, this space is not in a output. And if you want to see the output in a PDF file, you simply have to click on this MWE PDF generated in your folder, and you will get the same PDF here available. So this is how you can create the LaTeX document. Okay, and now we are going to see the LaTeX basic, that is how to create article and all the LaTeX basic with that in our next tutorial. Till then, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to click on the bell icon and share it, comment it, and like it. Thank you very much.